everyone. Thanks for tuning in to Spotlight on Real Estate today. Today we have Nick Macaron today from Oxford Mortgage. Him and his whole entire team do such a great job with my clients. They're one of my two preferred vendors. And today I just want to touch base and talk about refinancing. We hear a lot about this in the news with rates being so low, record lows, and all of that. We just want to touch base. So Nick, can you expand on what's required, what it looks like, how long the process goes?
Yeah, absolutely, Renee. Thanks for having me. It's a great time right now to refinance for a lot of people. Rates are at near historic lows. For example, today we locked somebody at 3.125 on a 30-year fix. So they're that kind of low. There are some challenges right now with refinances, with the COVID-19 stuff we're all dealing with, as far as verifications of employment and things like that. So you will need to be in a position where you can get financing, you can be at work, or we can start the process and not be able to close until you get back to work. So that's definitely an option. As far as timeframes are concerned, we're closing stuff as quickly as we were prior. So right now we're saying 21 days to 30 days for a refinance. Typically 30 to 40 for a purchase, really more for appraisal timeframe reasons or inspection reasons. But for refinances, 3 weeks to 30 days is what we're doing right now.
Okay.
And another great benefit of a refinance right now that a lot of people are taking advantage of in these uncertain economic times is cash out, right? A lot of people are seeing the opportunity to grab a little bit of their home equity, put it in their savings while they can. So that's a great possibility for someone who might want to have some cash for the future. Outside of that, the guidelines are pretty normal. Debt to income ratios, we can still go up to 45% for conventional, 55% for FHA and VA. No huge changes there. Credit scores typically right now, and this is temporary. When this all ends, they'll be kind of get back to some normalcy on some of the guideline fronts. But we really want to see 680 and above for credit score. Okay. Right now it's business as usual. Rates are excellent. We're saving people, $300-$500 a month on rate term refinances, and also paying off all sorts of debt through cash out refinances.
So if a homeowner's been in their home 2 to 3 years,
yeah,
and they haven't refinanced, chances are their rate's going to be lower and they're going to have some equity that they can tap into. Is that about right?
Yeah. I mean, of course it depends on how much they put down when they bought, mm-hmm. right? And what their rate was then. But yeah, I mean, rates are pretty much as low as they've ever been right now. So, I mean, I think whether it be with me or with somebody else, it is definitely a good time to at least explore that option to see, what makes sense. Mm-hmm. It's also an excellent time to maybe try to get out of a 30-year and into a shorter term, 25, 20, 15, whatever, because I think people would be surprised at how close to their current payment, say a 20-year fixed would be, and possibly shave some time off that amortization period.
Yeah, so you're paying interest over time, essentially.
Yeah, exactly right. So I think, it's definitely worth exploring. And like I said, there's a lot of people right now that have substantial credit card debts, car loans, student loans, things like that, that, if their equity will allow it, they could save themselves a substantial amount of money monthly, as well as paying less in interest on some of that longer term stuff like student loans and credit cards.
So as far as cost for refinancing, yeah, there is a cost for an appraisal. About what's the general amount? I know because each one is very specific.
Yeah.
What's the general amount people can assume to pay to refinance?
Yeah, that's as far as closing costs are concerned, I think a good number, if you do need an appraisal, a safe number to assume would be, $3,500. Something like that for closing costs. Mm-hmm. Now you do have your prepaids, and that's the one that varies substantially on every deal, right? How much are they going to need for insurance? How many months are we going to have to collect for taxes, things like that. So it's a hard question. I mean, every deal is a little bit different, but, you know, I would say for just closing costs, you're probably looking at, you know, $3,500 with title, appraisal, underwriting. I mean, that's obviously every deal is different, but that's probably a pretty good number for just the closing costs.
And those can be paid at closing through, say, if you're pulling out a little bit of equity, you don't have to have that money in the bank. Yeah. You can actually take that from the equity that you're taking out of the house, right?
So assuming you've got the equity, right? And mm-hmm. you know, if you're going, let's say you're doing a refinance and you're going to 80% of the appraisal, mm-hmm. You can roll those costs into the loan as long as there's enough room to do that within that loan to value.
Absolutely.
So yes, 100%. If not, you can of course do a portion of it, or you can bring it in, however you want to do that. Now, I will say most people don't bring money to closing. Most people roll that in, you know, obviously you're paying interest on it over 30, 20, 15 years, whatever. But a lot of people say, hey, I'm going to roll 5,000 in and raise my payment by $25 instead of taking 5,000 out of my savings account.
So right.
A lot of different options there.
Liquidity and what your financial plan is. And that's exactly right. That's where your team comes in with a lot of experience and a lot of knowledge in that area.
Right. And we're going to give them different options, right? We're going to say, hey, here it is with you bringing the funds to close. Here it is with you rolling it in. Here's a 15, here's a 20, you know, different things for them to kind of sit down at the dinner table with their spouse and mull over and see what fits best for them. And, you know, and then we'll go from there.
So another two things to keep in mind is that you could possibly get rid of your PMI, mm-hmm. Which is just mortgage insurance that you're paying to the bank that says, you know, I'm good for this house, sure. And this mm-hmm. loan is good. And then another thing is depending on when you close, do you have about a month without any mortgage payment?
Yes. So first thing, mortgage insurance, that's a great reason to look at a refinance, especially if you're in an FHA loan where the mortgage insurance is not going to fall off on its own, like it will on conventional.
Right.
With rates where they're at, even if you qualify for a conventional loan and can get into one, the factor that they calculate, even if you still have to have mortgage insurance, the calculation and the factor to come up with that number is considerably less on conventional, assuming good credit. Okay, so that's the first thing. It's a great, and addressing mortgage insurance is a great reason to refinance. As far as skipping payments, yeah, if you were to close in April, you would not have a May payment. First payment would be June 1st. You can also potentially roll in your April payment and skip April and May. First payment, June 1st. So now, of course, there's more interest in your payoff.
Right.
Right. But again, that's a decision that, you know, we'll go over with the borrower so they can make a decision on what they want to do. But a lot of borrowers choose to skip those two payments and basically roll that April payment into their payoff.
So just sort of to sum this all up, you know, you're not just refinancing to pay less on the interest rate each month. You're also possibly dropping a portion that you're paying for no reason, the PMI, essentially. Right. You're also being able to extend the liquidity of your money, potentially by extracting some equity out. Right. And then possibly you're skipping a mortgage payment. So there's multitude of reasons for people to reach out to you and sit down and meet and go through those options.
Yeah, listen, I mean, we tell people all the time, it may or may not be a good time to refinance mm-hmm. for you and your specific scenario, but we do recommend that if you have questions about it, let's sit down, let's chat about what you're trying to accomplish, right? And just see if we look at your whole financial picture, car payments, credit cards, student loans, are you better served to just refinance your mortgage and lower your payment? Are you better served to pay off these other debts? What's going to be the best scenario for you individually? Because everybody's scenario is different. But you know, with rates where they are right now, I think it's everybody needs to do their due diligence and at least look at it and see what kind of options are available.
Great. So go ahead and your information will all be in the video below, and I'm going to go ahead and ask everybody to go ahead and subscribe to this to my channel so that you can catch up on all the spotlights and get notification when they come on. And then, Nick, do you just want to give them your information on the video right now?
Yeah, absolutely. So my name's Nick Macaron. My partner, Mike True, Greg Sipple, Lindsay Walsh, we're all here to, help meet your mortgage needs. Our phone number at the office is 303-221-9022. And my email is nick@oxfordmtgc.com.
Great. Nick, thank you so much for coming on today. I really appreciate it. I feel like there are a lot of people that just needed this information simplified, and you did a great job with that. And I, you guys, subscribe below. We've got content coming various times throughout the week and lots of it. So be plugged in, subscribe. And if you're contemplating refinance or maybe checking out your options, be sure to contact Nick. Again, information below the video. Thanks for tuning in. Bye-bye.